has shown, with both of his hands. Now, supposing it is your right wrist that has been seized, you will reach over with your left palm, curling it under your right palm. With the aid of your left arm, you will pull your captured arm up to your shoulder, taking care at the same time to keep the thumb side of the captured arm uppermost. The hold will be broken. Now, should both your wrists be seized, extend your arms straight before you, bending your back and forcing your wrists downwards. This forces your assailant to bend his wrists, and it thus weakens his hold. Now, twist your captured wrists to the outside, taking care to keep the thumb sides of the captured wrists uppermost, and you will be able to wrench free. The hold will then be broken.
Should you wish to throw your opponent to the left, you seize his right arm, at the same time placing the ball of your thumb against the ball of his, and with your right hand at the back of the captured hand, then bending the hand over, and with a circular movement, throwing your opponent to the left.
Now, should you be attacked from behind, and either arm is thrown round your neck with the object of pulling you to the ground, you will then place both hands either side of your opponent's elbow. You then lean your shoulder forward, give a circular movement of the hips, and pull both hands downwards. All this done simultaneously will be sufficient to throw your victim. This throw is very effective and much more suitable to ladies than some of the others because it needs no strength at all. The palm of the right or left hand should be placed under the chin of the opponent, at the same time placing the corresponding leg at the back of the heels of your opponent. With an upward pressure of the hand under the chin, it will be quite sufficient to throw your victim to the ground.